Andy in the attic here with a life pro tip, how to be successful in life in just about anything you ever do. Now, it's really, really simple, and I would think it'd be a fundamental, but it's something that I've noticed people have a bit of trouble with. It's really simple, be on time. In fact, even better than that, turn up just a little bit early. Picture the following scene. You've arranged to meet somebody, say in a bar, restaurant, or whatever, at say 8 p.m. and you're there at 5:02, they're not. And then 8 p.m. arrives and they're still not there. And about 10 past, they turn up. Think about all the thoughts that are likely to have gone through your head and the mental imaginations and all the other stuff in those 15, 20 minutes while you were waiting. Most of them won't be positive, and a lot of them will be actually quite negative. Now imagine an employer or somebody you've got an appointment with is going through a similar set of mental machinations because you're not there. You might only be a minute late, but it doesn't matter. Because even if the person is expecting you, say, at 10 a.m. and you're there at 1 minute past, they have still entered that thought process. There's an immediate doubt. Is this individual turning up? Are they going to be here? Have I wasted my time? Just imagine, you're someone like me who tends to work to very strict time schedules and pretty busy. So if I make time in my diary to fit somebody in for, say, an hour appointment, and that's an hour given up, and meanwhile, there's plenty of other stuff I could be booking in place because things are always stacking up, and then that person doesn't turn up. Or, actually, they do turn up, they're 10 minutes late. As you can imagine, I'm not too pleased. And in the minutes that I'm waiting, I'm thinking, have I just wasted my time here? Think of all the things I've turned down in order to make availability for this individual. Now, those are the things that the person who is habitually late is pretty much doing to everybody that knows them. They're also demonstrating something fundamental. They're simply not reliable. When I run workshops, I tend to notice who's there first, and I also notice the people that arrive right in the nick of time. Usually, say, if I start at 10 a.m., they walk in the door at 10 a.m. I notice those things. I notice the people who are habitually late, and it drives me nuts. I can predict who will be successful. I can also predict who is suitably arrogant to actually not have a care that they're keeping other people waiting. Let's face it, if I'm arranged to meet you somewhere or have an appointment with you, but I'm not there because I'm basically doing something else, that something else has more value to me than you do. And that's the thing that's communicated loud and clear. Now, I'm not talking about the occasional time when somebody's, like, there's the unavoidable events, such as traffic and stuff like that. I'm talking about the people who swan in and then they're late back from the break, they're late back from lunch, and so on. And they often have to go early too. My all-time favorite, and some of you watching this video may well have been at this particular training event. So I was running a course, and on the first day, we would have had an hour for lunch, and somebody asked, can we truncate, make the lunch break a lot shorter so we can finish earlier? Did a show of hands, and people were quite happy to say half an hour for lunch, that's enough time. Yep, half an hour it is. A couple of people weren't too pleased, but majority wins, and so we said, okay, let's go for half an hour. Now, at lunchtime, after about 25 minutes, everyone else is back in the room having rushed their lunch. The one person who didn't come in for yet another hour after we started was the very person who asked to have a truncated lunchtime. And as you can imagine, people weren't too impressed with that individual. Neither was I, because I thought, why did I change the plan for that individual? Actually, I should have stuck with what I had scheduled in. And somebody made a comment as she walked in the room. It was quite a cutting comment, and it was quite witty. And she got really angry. Yeah, how dare someone speak to her that way? And to me, it just demonstrated the conceit. So, my point being, if you want to be successful in life, you want to communicate reliability and dependency. Dependability, that's the word. Reliability and dependability. be on time. Actually, do better. Just be a little bit early. You'll be amazed at what starts to happen in your life as people start to treat you as a reliable, dependable person.